character and personality development. Apart from your skills, physical well-being, and life purpose, your character and personality comprise major areas of your personal development. After all, it is your virtues that shape your influence on others and create your legacy. Resilience. The state of your emotional well-being determines how resilient you are. In the face of adversity, many people are unable to cope with the negative consequences and setbacks. The ability to deal with adversity is known as resilience. While not many are blessed with this quality, the good news is that you can practice and build resilience over time. With resilience, you will be more conscious of yourself and your surroundings and will be able to control your emotions better. Rather than mull over a negative or unexpected situation, resilient people look for creative solutions and take their ordeals as learning opportunities. Resilient people are highly self-aware and acknowledge that life is full of ups and downs. One day, you're enjoying the fruits of your labor, and the other, you are forced to tackle unexpected situations. One of the most remarkable qualities of resilient people is their ability to be so resourceful. They will find solutions to problems by utilizing the knowledge they have developed and the strong connection they have built with others. If you cannot adapt to change or find it difficult to face trauma, incorporate these practices in your life to build resilience. Join community help groups. As mentioned, resilient people are very resourceful and always enjoy strong support from their group. Making connections and forging relationships is key to building a resilient spirit. Clubs and online forums or groups are examples of places to meet like-minded people and foster long-lasting relationships. Adopt a practical mindset. At times, being practical is the only way out of intense, stressful issues. Rather than ponder over what went wrong, build a step-by-step strategy to remedy the problem at hand. Being proactive will only help you become more resilient. For example, if you ever face a job loss, do not waste time being upset or convincing your boss to take you back. Instead, learn from your mistakes and build new skills to boost your market value. Apply for new jobs and secure interviews after revamping your resume. Stay on the move. While taking time off to avoid feeling overwhelmed is natural, do not let minor setbacks turn into permanent ordeals. Get back up on your feet and keep moving forward to achieve your goals. Do not focus on speed. Going slow is better than not moving at all, after all. Generosity and kindness. More often than not, how kind and generous you are is a reliable indicator of your character worth. Adopt a giving attitude and do not expect anything in return. It is the best way to create a sense of purpose and feel worthy. Being generous isn't always about going out of your way and giving more than you have. It also isn't about giving material possessions. It can be a random act of kindness, such as buying a homeless person a meal or volunteering at a local charity event. By paying it forward, you are doing what's right, and this is bound to reciprocate in incredible ways. That said, you should not focus on being generous just for the sake of receiving something in return. Good deeds only count if you give without expectations. This way, you can connect with others and create positivity around you. Humility. Being humble and grounded is an equally significant yet underrated virtue, sometimes considered old school or unfashionable. In reality, being humble involves accepting your qualities and flaws and being aware of them. To be humble, a person knows they may not always be right and should consider the opinions of others in matters that they are unfamiliar with. This acceptance is often challenging, which is why developing humility can prove quite difficult. Humility is often confused with having low self-esteem. This is a grave misconception. Being humble means putting yourself on equal footing with others. Put differently, humility is the power to acknowledge that you are not perfect and you can improve in many areas of your life. The point isn't to belittle your self-worth and accomplishments. As such, the gap between realizing that you are not perfect and thinking less of yourself is where self-improvement kicks in. It is easier for people in lesser positions to be humble. Those in greater positions are often pompous because they know they are highly valued by members of society. Since others constantly seek their help, developing humility can be difficult. There are several examples of influential leaders who are quite humble, such as Mahatma Gandhi and former U.S. President Barack Obama. You can develop humility and become more grounded by following these golden rules. Listen before you speak. Your words can leave a strong impact on people, and as you know, words can hurt. Speaking mindlessly can provoke misunderstandings and arguments, which can also jeopardize valuable relationships. When responding to someone or expressing your point of view, think of what you would like to say before speaking and truly reflect on it to see if it fits your situation. Talk only when necessary. Never interrupt, and let the other person finish before you respond. Ask for opinions and feedback. You can learn something from everyone. At times, seeking different viewpoints and being exposed to new perspective breaks the barrier and provides new forms of learning. Give honest compliments. This will show your appreciation and respect for other people's qualities and that you are not always full of yourself. Try to find something positive in everyone and compliment people warmly and honestly. Although this might sound anecdotal or ineffective, smiling can go a long way in strengthening your character and rapport with others. You not only come across as a more positive and attractive person, but the person in front of you is likely to mirror the same emotion. Whether it's your loved one or the Uber driver, smile at everyone and maintain a cheerful face. Thank the people you are grateful for and those who stand by you during difficult times. More importantly, stay in good touch with the people who matter to you and from those who you can learn from. Master your craft. Invariably, learning a new skill will boost your confidence, self-esteem, and versatility. In fact, acquiring knowledge, building new skills, and mastering your craft will bring you closer to like-minded people and promote your growth. You will be more valued in your professional endeavors as well. Learn something new every once in a while and shuffle your interests to avoid monotony and stagnation. You can also take up two skills at once. For example, if you're learning to cook today, pair it with a new language course. Since both activities are different and require different skills, you will enjoy learning and mastering them simultaneously. Learning a new skill should not be an obligation. Only go for it if you are genuinely interested and see its potential benefits. Otherwise, you will give it up eventually, which will result in a lot of wasted time and effort. Taking up a skill should not come at the expense of your work and prior commitments. Time management is key to a good, sustainable routine. If you are not able to find the time, conduct DIY projects during the weekend. Fix the broken window in your house, or build that new set of shelves you were going to buy for your bedroom. Take up a challenge and finish it. If you need help, look for online resources, watch tutorials, or call a friend or your mentor. Do not feel intimidated. You would be surprised at how many hidden talents and skills reside inside of you. In parallel, and as mentioned early on, polishing your existing skills will make you better at what you do and set you apart from your competition. Mastering your craft will help a great deal in developing your personality and strengthening your persona. What is the point of self-improvement? We are all going to die one day. Is it even worth trying? The fact that we only have one life to enjoy should be reason enough to get excited and seek to better ourselves. The time you spend on this earth should be full of happiness and adventures. Living in the present and celebrating each moment is the true meaning of life. And this can only be experienced with a willingness to grow. Self-improvement and growth are vital to living a fulfilling and gratifying life. You are not just spending the years you are given, but leaving a legacy as well. Your story will be perpetrated through your heirs, and your memories will be etched into the minds of your loved ones long after you have departed. While this might strike you as too philosophical, it should not be taken for granted. The concept of self-improvement is not a myth. It can, and will considerably, impact your life. To sum it all up, let's quote this famous saying by popular author Miguel Ruiz. If you can see yourself as an artist, and you can see that your life is your own creation, then why not create the most beautiful story for yourself? We have a couple of decades to live, so let's make our existence worthwhile. Do you feel inspired to take the leap and kickstart your journey toward self-improvement and character development? Remember, it is never too late to become the best version of yourself. So what are you waiting for? Get out there and make an impact on both yourself and the world.